So all of you know that one of my pet surgeries, or one of the surgeries that I love doing the most, is rhinoplasty. And for any plastic surgery, but rhinoplasty more specifically, imaging, computer imaging, and all these types of things are super uber important. So over Christmas, I guess I bought myself a new gift, and I have a new toy, and you're probably looking at this fancy thing going, what is this? And this is actually a 3D imaging processor, which allows us to really look at the face in 3D, look at things like angles and volumes and things like that to, one, have better communication with our patients about what we can really achieve in the operating room. Two, allows us to better plan surgically what we're going to do in the operating room. And three, judge our results. So it's kind of an awesome thing. So I'm gonna actually bring the camera over here so you can actually look and see what the 3D model looks like. So this is a 3D photograph we shot of Deb up front today. So you can see, you can rotate it, you can see what the nostrils look like, the basal view. So it's super cool. And this allows us to actually image the nose in three dimensions. So here we can see, first of all, here is our original 3D model here. And I'm going to take off the things that I've been messing around with. But here's our original 3D model. And the first thing we've got is some of the calculations that we use in order to do an appropriate rhinoplasty. So things like nasolabial angle, the nasal angle to the face, all of these various types of things are things that we use whenever we're calculating the appropriate aesthetics of a rhinoplasty. Now, the additional cool thing about the software is it also gives you certain amount of information on the 3D model. For example, this is the symmetry of the face. And you can see that these three models are pretty symmetrical, because what this is the two left halves of the face pasted together. This is the true image, and this is the two right halves pasted together. It also gives us what the proportionality of the face is. So these are some of the metrics or the objective measures that we use when doing a rhinoplasty. Now, the coolest thing about this program is this. So let's say hypothetically I want to model, let's go for a rhino on her. One way of doing this is I can kind of actually use the little slider tool in order to adjust this dorsum and things like that. So there you can see me adjusting the dorsum. For further fine tuning, I have the capacity of circling this section right here, and then I can bring that down a little bit. Okay, so now the cool thing is not only do you see the effect of this on the side profile, but in real life, there's actually effects of this in 3D on the front profile. So you can see now, we can do a side by side in this panel. Let's go ahead and put the frontal image, and you can see how, pardon me, I'm just trying to get all this done here. So you can see how the side profile is affected, and the front profile stays relatively the same. So therefore, this is some of the cool stuff that we can do with this 3D modeling. The further cool stuff, we can actually see a volume model and see where the different volumes are on the face and how they're impacted by various types of imaging. The other thing that I really do like about this software, one of the cool things that I do like about this software, is for the first time this model is relatively realistic. Prior iterations of 3D modeling that I've used before have a very alien or, you know, non-humanoid model, which makes it very difficult. And this actually looks pretty damn realistic, which is really cool. Here's some examples of moving in. I don't know how clearly you can see this on the iPad, but moving in the tip a little bit and seeing what that looks like. So it has a lot of abilities to do a couple of different things on here, and which are very powerful. So this is just a quick little primer, things that we can image. Of course, rhinoplasty, chin augmentation is something that can be imaged on here. So you can see, for example, if I put a profile picture, that's the easiest way to do this. We can give her more of a chin and then look and see what that looks like on frontal profile with more of a chin. So these are all things that can be done with the 3D modeling software. And it's really a tool that we can use to further communicate what is surgically possible. Now, one of the key things which is really important with this software and any other modeling software is that I really do feel in my recommendation that the surgeon should be the one who's doing such modeling, because he knows what is physically capable in the operating room. This, of course, is a computer software program. It doesn't know what is really capable in the operating room, what is realistic, what can be done. These types of things are not something that a computer software program is going to know. The surgeon does know what can be done based on anatomy, based on skin thickness, based on his experiences. And therefore, that is why it is so important that the surgeon actually does this type of modeling, because it really is a communication tool between patient and surgeon. So I hope you guys are just as excited about this as I am, because I think that this is, as I would like to say, mind-blowing. All right, cool. If you've got more questions about imaging, 3D computer simulation, rhinoplasty, whatever it is, give us a shout. Looking forward to chatting with you.